Hello, welcome back to another episode. In a previous episode, we found out what happened to Greenglade. Now we've got to go back to Lot Yonan. We know our pathway. Here we go now. We'll head over to that location.
Every evening since you left Greenglade, you have looked at Goren's books and tried to prize out the knowledge that they hold. But now, you must admit to yourself that you can't decipher them. They are written in the learned language for High Magi. And Lot Yonan didn't teach you that. However, you're sure that the books are important. Why else would Garen want them sent to Turga the Fair-Faced? You put them away with a sigh, and your eyes remain on the bag that Lot Yonan gave you. Did Garen ask Lot Yonan to return the magical artifacts in the pouch? You pick up the pouch and look at it.
Lot Yonan forbade me from opening the pouch.
Lot Yonan trusted you with the pouch. You don't want to betray that trust. You look at it for a moment longer, but then you close the rucksack and pack it away. But your curiosity is not so easily contained and keeps you awake in the night.
Okay, we'll keep moving on. Look, all I know about a dwarf is that magic and a dwarf does not mix very well.
Just like previous nights, you are haunted by the image of the elf maiden nailed to the tree in Greenglade. You wake from your sleep and look around you. The night is unusually dark. Despite your good dwarven eyes, you can only make out Boendal's outline, even though he's keeping watch only a few steps away. You're about to lie down again, but suddenly feel something cold against your throat. Next to you, the pale face of an alf slides into view.
Good evening. I'm afraid we missed each other in Greenglade. So my companion had to receive you on her own.
You want to speak, but the blade is pressed against your larynx, and you can only manage a wheeze.
Shush! You don't need to talk. I'm not going to kill you.
Not yet.
Do you know what I'm going to do instead?
You feverishly search for an answer. But you can't even imagine how an alpha thinks.
I will kill everyone who means anything to you. I will destroy your life, and you will sink into hopelessness, groundling. Your downfall is called Synthoras.
You tense your muscles, readying to defend yourself, but suddenly realize that the blade against your throat has disappeared. You look around, astonished. The elf is nowhere to be seen. You look over to Boendal, who is easy to recognize in the bright moonlight. Next to you, Boendil smacks his lips in his sleep. You touch your throat, and when you don't feel anything, you breathe out, relieved.
Just a nightmare.
At least that's what you tell yourself. But you don't close your eyes for the rest of the night.
Lovely. That is a portent of a very bad thing to come, for sure. Let's keep on moving now. We'll head over here.
Boendil unwraps his dwarf cheese again and cooks it on the fire. When he offers you a piece, you take it.
I knew we'd make a dwarf of you in the end!
You chew on the cheese so you don't have to answer. It tastes better than you first thought.
Oh, lovely. Dirty cheese.
You arrive at a small, bustling village. One thing is clearly missing from the lively scene. The sound of metal on metal from the village smithy that would normally be heard above everything else at this time of day. A dour, grim-looking man is sitting in front of the forge with his right arm in a sling. His expression brightens as he sees you, and he jumps to his feet.
Dear dwarves, could I interest you in helping me in my workshop for a day?
The man's expression is somewhere between desperation and hope. As you don't answer immediately, he continues.
You will, of course, be royally rewarded for your work. I can offer you 100 gold pieces.
You'd have to pay me now. Let's go look around.
What happened to your arm?
A stupid accident. A box of blanks fell down. I was trying to catch it. It will heal, fortunately. But I won't be able to wield my hammer for a while.
You must have quite a backlog of work.
You nod sympathetically. You always felt bad if you were ill or couldn't work in the forge for some reason or other.
Loads. But if what I hear about the metalworking skills of the dwarves is true, it would be easy for you to manage it in a day.
Yeah, I don't really trust them. We don't have time for that right now.
You shake your head.
We don't have time, sorry.
The smith seems downhearted, but lets you go. As you leave the village, you notice two horsemen standing on a small hill, no more than 30 yards away, watching you.
Can we help you?
For a moment, you think the horsemen didn't hear you. Then one of the horsemen leans to the other and says something that you can't understand this far off. They turn on their horses and gallop off.
What was that about? Are they scared of us?
You don't reply to Boindeel, but it does all seem a bit strange. You continue on your way with unanswered questions weighing on your mind.
That is a bit weird. Okay. We'll head over here. Yeah, that's what we'll do. We can go to that fisherman's village and they'll ferry me across. I did save them all, which means they'll be very kind to me. There we go. Beautiful. Now we can go over here.
You see a light through the tree some way from the path. It inevitably brings to mind your encounter with the woodcutters. You tell the dwarves about your encounter with the woodcutters and how you intimidated them.
Ha! Very dwarf-like, but I think we'll have to teach them a lesson anyway.
Humans are not our enemies, Boindeel.
You must confess that you'd have liked to have taught the woodcutters a lesson, but Boindeel is right.
Beating up humans is not our mission.
But...
A harsh glance from you and Boindeel silences Boindeel. You continue on your way with a furious Boindeel trailing behind.
I get why he's mad, but it isn't the way to go about it. They are ignorant people, uneducated and whatnot.
I don't like it here. All this hocus-pocus is bad news. Us dwarves know that and keep well away, just as Vrakus commanded. I hope you know that too.
I cannot perform magic, and I've never attempted to. Nevertheless, please show respect. Remember that it was Lot Yonan who took me in and saved me.
Now then, it would seem that the tongue of the learned one becomes somewhat haughtier, and his sentences doth wind most strangely as we verily approach the vaults.
You can't help but grin guiltily. With a beseeching glance at the twins, you step into the area in front of the vaults. Seeing no one there you might greet, you and your companions enter your old home through the open gate.
I'm a little bit worried about what we'll find here. I'm hoping they're okay, but I don't know. They might not be now. He's gonna be gone.
Who the hell built this tunnel?
Boindeel examines the crumbling roof with a mixture of disbelief and indignation.
Be quiet. I want to surprise them.
Is that such a good idea? What if we give your master such a shock that he casts a spell on us? I don't want to be turned into a mouse or a bar of soap.
It is unusually quiet in the vaults, but the smell of dinner is in the air. You imagine Frala looking up at you from her cooking pot in the kitchen and smiling.
Ah, there's boiled and roasted meat for dinner. Come on.
That's no reason to go and get ourselves turned into something weird. We'll stay here until you're finished with your little game.
Yeah, all right. They can wait there. They're pretty mad. It's okay, I'll finish my job. Here's the kitchen. Where are they all at?
Lumps of meat rise up and appear on the brown, bubbling surface of the soup before sinking back down out of sight. The hearty smell makes your mouth water.
Oh! A human foot?
Your stomach turns, and you have to fight hard against the impulse to run out of the kitchen screaming.
I knew it. Great.
The cradle's empty. Your stomach tightens. You refuse to believe it, but you can't help thinking of the soup again.
No. It can't be true.
Speaking it out loud helps, but it doesn't get rid of the bad feeling completely.
What about over here? No, nothing in here. I'll check my forge and then his own study. They're all gone.
You look around the workshop with growing panic. No one to be seen.
Nothing for me to look at in here? Okay. Well, let's go into the room. Great. I wish they would join me, but they're not gonna do that right now, are they? No.
What happened here? Speak!
Ah, another one.
Don't even think of using magic, or I'll lodge this pretty piece of steel in your brain.
It takes the Famulus a few seconds to comprehend the situation he suddenly found himself in. He seems to weigh up his options for a moment before he breathes out and the tension leaves his body.
All right. I won't use magic.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
For a while, the Famulus seems to be playing with the idea of being stubborn. Bowendal pushes a little harder on the end of the crow's beak, and the tip penetrates the skin. Blood seeps out.
Ow! They're gone! Dead!
A school full of magi destroyed without any signs of struggle? Lies!
The facts seem stacked against it, but you cling on to this faint hope.
Lot Yonan's famuli were already in Parista. There are only novices left. We made easy work of them. The Elfar, Syntharas, he insisted on being part of the raid after he found out that you grew up here. He opened the gates and killed most of those here before they even knew what was happening.
In your mind's eye, you see a pale face appearing from the darkness. You saw what Elfar are capable of in Greenglade. You push the thought to the back of your mind and try to keep a clear head.
Lot Yonan, where is he?
Nodon killed him. He killed all of them in Parista. There's no one left in Girdlegard who can take on the last Magus.
You're saying that someone took on all six of the Magi at once and defeated them? Ridiculous.
Five Magi. My master Nudin is Nodon the Doublefold, the Lord of the Perished Land and soon to be Lord of Girdlegard. He killed the masters, and the apprentices followed soon after. They're all gone, and he changed the magic field so that only we can use them.
An icy hand grabs your heart. It's impossible that there's only a single Magus left, and he's not fighting against, but for the Perished Land.
Why are you snooping around in Lot Yonan's study? What are you looking for?
I'm looking for artifacts that Lot Yonan, when he was in Parista, claimed he had forgotten and left in a cupboard. And for the books that were stolen from Greenglade. I'm guessing you're the dwarves that stole the books.
What does your master want with the artifacts and the books?
I don't know. He commands, we obey. He's going to be very displeased. I did find a bag in the cupboard, but it didn't contain the right objects.
I've had enough of your lies. They're alive. Lot Yonan escaped and has gathered his apprentices, Frala, and the others around him to fight against Nodon. We just have to find them.
The war was over before you even noticed it had begun. Nodon cannot be stopped. He is on his way here and will just...
Blah, blah. We will leave immediately. This news is of great importance to the Council of Dwarves.
I'm not going anywhere. I have to find my friends and I...
Orcs! Lots of them!
Great, here we go. Time for a huge fight. I'm not happy about what's happening, but I had a feeling. I did. Alright, let's go beat him back. Now we fight. Oh, we all get to fight now. Alright, so hold on. Here's what I'll do. Knock him back for a bit. A bit like that, yeah. We'll come over here. Oh, I can break down the pillars? Really?
Whew. Not bad.
With pleasure.
Huh? Hold on. Get you to move.
Yes.
Tungdil, you've done your part.
Yeah. I didn't hit you very hard.
Good work. Abracus. There's so many of them. I've got to kill 30, though. Only 30. Not too bad. Okay. We'll have you move over here, then. Yeah. Can you do that? Yeah, I can. Oh, ran into that. What? Not good.
Put up a fight.
No, they're knocking back.
Oh,
Bowendil's got it.
Yes.
We have so many to take down right now. Okay. I'm gonna knock a few off their feet. There we go. I'm able to hit a few more now. Let's go knock down more of them. And kill more of them. Bowendil can handle it. I won't lie to you. I really thought it was gonna be a lighthearted fantasy. Things got dark rather quickly. Kill more of them. You will be able to. Hold on. Kill that one. Kill that one. You nearly killed 30. There's just so many of them. We'll use that amulet. That way we can heal up.
There are too many of them.
The side door in the workshop. It's our only chance.
Oh great. We gotta somehow get over there. Let me try to figure out how I'm gonna do it. First off, I'm gonna charge through. That way we can clear on through, if I can. Alright. Where are you at, my friend? You're over here. Yeah, they're pretty close. Let's keep on moving, let's keep on moving. Tungdil? I'm gonna need you to charge in again. I hope you don't hit anything. Good, you didn't. We actually killed more of them. That was a beautiful escape! That worked out! We did it! Great, he's level 5 already. What will I give you? Cleave. You have Mighty Blow. Eruption. I like the idea of you having Cleave. But you do have Mighty Blow. You're not very mobile right now. You being able to move quickly is very powerful. Alright, I'll give you Cleave. I like him just being an immobile tank. Now we can get out of here.
Damn. The first 20 are mine!
You have come far, but this is far enough. Give me the artifacts and the books you stole in Greenglade, and I'll set you free.
What's with the artifacts and the books?
They belong to me. Lotionan was supposed to bring them to Porista, but forgot them. So, I came to pick them up. That's all you need to know.
You wanting my rucksack is enough reason for me not to give it to you.
I don't need your consent. Look after the rucksack. If you lose it, you will also lose your life.
What have you done to the other Magi? Your Famulus told us some cock and bull story about you forcing them and their Famuli to go to Parista and then murdering them.
I did what had to be done to protect Girdle Guard. I wish there had been another way. But they would never have understood.
Do your eyes deceive you, or do you really see a brief moment of real regret on the swollen face of the Magus?
Go back to your realm, dwarves, and let your king know that I need his land. Either he hands it over without a drop of blood being spilt, or my troops and allies take it by force. You can take this one with you. I have no use for him.
Invisible wizard, my ass.
Look.
Let me handle her. Kill the dwarves.
Oh boy. Alright, time for another fight.
The rucksack! The artifacts! If he wants them so badly, they might be the key to his destruction.
There's the orc with the rucksack! Let's get him!
He put up okay. A fight. Huh? Let's go look at it. I gotta go recover that immediately, which means I need to charge through. That's how we do it. Oh, come on. I thought we had it for a moment. I'm gonna have to leap over there. There we go. Oh, got away. There we go. We got it. Whew. Okay, so now we need to get over the bridge. There's some heroes fighting. I don't know who they are. Only one of them, then. Okay. So, I need to get over here now. That charge is incredibly useful for me. Alright, Bowen Doll, let's get you the hell out. Get over here. Bowen Dill. We're getting you out too, my friend. Come on. Alright, now we need Bowen Doll. It could be difficult to get them all out. Hold on. Soak him in. Blow him back. Now, should I move through? Yeah, if I had charge, I would be able to get him. I had a feeling that would have been a good call, but too late. Yeah, we'll move him through. Keep on fighting. She's rather powerful. I like her already. Okay. Let's move you through in a little while. I have to use your abilities. She's getting a lot of damage. Yeah, they are. Come on. He's tanking a lot. I've got to make it through. So. Alright, I need to cut my way through then. Get them. Unlock him back if I can. You're taking way too much damage, my friend. Knock him down. Come on. Let's get you over here and knock a few more down. You can guard him. We'll guard him. We'll try to guard him. Alright, I need to change up my point of view. The battles are getting much harder for sure. Okay, let's move. I need you to move too. Okay, so we made it over here now. Look at that orc. We knocked him down. That's a very powerful way to fight. Okay, now you get to do some battling too.
Say goodbye forever. As good as done.
Let's go.
Let's get out of here.
Retreat? We should fight on.
We would die. Perhaps you've noticed that Nodon has risen again, headless. He is more powerful than the Perish Land itself, but the key to his destruction is in here.
We will return to the Secondlings and tell them what the Magus is up to. We'll be safe at Ogre's death, and there we can hatch a plan.
If we manage to get there. Nodon will do anything to stop us.
Then let him try!
We need to get out now. We're pretty injured. Oh, okay. I have to get that one. Oink, oink. I'll take it. More provisions that we need and more gold. Now we can get out. Where are we going to go now? Ah, oh, what? The map is really big. Wow. No joke. Is it orc herd?
That was fun. What's next?
Boindil looks at you, and the sparkle in his eyes goes out.
We are both very sorry about what happened here, Tungdil.
You told me, Cynthra said. I convinced myself that...
You gulp and turn away from your friends.
I hope we can rest for a brief moment. I really need some healing. I've taken a lot of injuries in that last battle. We couldn't help it, we were outnumbered.
Ha! That's what I call a goodly challenge! Cover me!
Not a good idea if you want to go on living, dwarf.
You've got quite a big mouth for someone who sounds like a girl!
You are Andikai, the Tempestuous, right?
Correct. And you are Tungdil. Lotjonan's charge.
Honorable Mager, what news of Lotjonan? Does he live?
Andekai looks at you in silence, pain and rage slowly spreading across her face. He is dead, Tungdil. Along with Myra, Turga, and Sabora. Nod On killed them all and destroyed the Council of Magi. The certainty of their death is painful. It feels as though someone has just torn your insides out. He killed their best pupils, too. And now he's the unchallenged Magus in Girdleguard.
It was you, wasn't it, that attacked them with the lightning? Were you any more successful than we were?
Andekai shakes her head. He defied everything I threw at him. All of my skills. In vain. I soon realized he was superior to me, but I wanted to buy you some time.
Nodon's famula said that he had changed the magical fields, but you still seem to be able to use them.
Andekai smiles. I'm not quite as benevolent as the other Magi. My god Samusin is the god of balance. He loves the darkness as much as the light, which means I can use both. But my powers aren't unlimited. It is difficult for me to store and use this altered magic. We should avoid confrontation as much as possible.
Your companion, won't he sit with us and introduce himself?
Yes! Hey! You up there! Can you even hear us with that bucket on your head?
Jerun is mute, and he won't do you any harm unless I command him to. And as long as you treat him with courtesy, dwarf. Boindil seems to briefly weigh up his chances against the two of them.
I decide when I'm courteous. Just don't get in my way. And the orcs are mine!
What happened? How could he defeat the Council of Magi?
Nudin called us to Perista, under the guise of reinforcing the barrier against the perished land. Instead, he tricked us, took control of most of our powers and attacked us. I cut him down with my sword, but he rose again and impaled me with his staff. All I can remember after that is the sound of fighting, destruction, and cries of death.
How did you survive?
Jerun. Nudin had forgotten he was with me in Perista. He found me, tended to my wounds and brought me out of the city to safety until I could summon up enough power to heal myself.
And Lotjonan?
When Jerun carried me away, he was frozen in stone, like a statue. To my knowledge, the spell cannot be reversed.
You nod slowly. You don't have the strength to say anything else right now.
What will you do now?
Leave this place. I'm not so foolish as to believe that I could restrain the perished land or Nod On. Why should I stay here?
Foolish, no! But cowardly!
You're on your way to the kingdom of the Secondlings, right? Then I will accompany you and leave Girdleguard by the High Pass.
We'll need all the help we can get. Nod On will have a lot worse in store for us than just orcs.
The Mager nods in agreement. Then she looks pensively at your rucksack.
Your rucksack? Why did Nod On want it?
I was taking some objects to Goren, one of Lotjonan's famuli. He was murdered at Greenglade by an alf. There were books lying next to his body which he was planning to send to Turga the Fairfaced.
May I see them?
You nod. Take the books out of your rucksack and hand them to her. She goes through the letter and the books, one after another, without showing any sign of emotion. Finally, she closes the last of the books.
Is that all? They are only sagas and travelogues from the Outer Lands, which tell of legendary creatures and myths. I don't know why they should be of interest to Nod On.
There must be something in them that's important to him. He destroyed a whole village for them, and the vault.
Possibly. I'll study the books. But let's sleep now. Jerun can keep watch. We are still being followed.
Okay, we'll trust her. I mean, he knew her. She must be okay then. Can't trust a guy called Nudin. I already knew that. Alright, there's that horde. I want to go help out that village. Oh, there we go.
It would seem that one of the armies who've been following you since Lot Yonan's vaults has caught up with you. You can even smell the rancid grease the orcs use on their weapons. Boindil immediately prepares to fight, but Andokai demands you avoid confrontation.
If we get caught up in a fight, they will surround us. The way southwards is more or less clear.
You agree with the Maegar. You decide to march through the night to increase the distance between you and them. The forced march is strenuous, but you manage to evade the army of orcs.
All right. We'll go then, because I have to. Let's keep on traveling. They're following me. Yeah, they really are. I'll have to fight one eventually, though, it looks like.
The army, you have put out a plate of food for the night every evening since Jerun and Andokai joined you on your journey. But still none of you have seen him eat. You decide to pay particular attention to him this evening to try and find out what is under the helmet. Andokai is sitting not far from the giant, studying the books.
Have you found anything useful yet?
She looks up at you.
You think I will stay and fight if there is a spell in the books that might defeat Nodon?
Yours is the god of balance. Don't you see it as your duty to create a balance between light and dark?
Instead of answering, Andokai rubs her eyes and closes the books.
It's too dark to study. Let's see what tomorrow brings.
Disgruntled, you watch the Maegar as she walks over to her bed for the night. Your eyes fall upon Jerun and the plate at his feet, on which not a crumb of food is left.
I'll have to buy a lot more food later. So we gotta head all the way over here. Alright, I can do that. I'm hoping we'll find food
in
eventually.
In the afternoon, with the sun low in the sky, the path leads you through a ravine. A glance at your map suggests that you're near to Boribor, the Orc realm.
Fracas, may we remain unscathed.
About a mile further on, Boindil suddenly stops in his tracks and sniffs.
Can you smell that? Piggy snouts! And lots of them too!
Let's proceed with caution. Perhaps we can take a few of them out before they raise the alarm.
No, here we go. Time to find out what she can do in battle. I wonder how many I can have to control all the ones, I have no idea. Okay, I can't have that many. So that's how I do that, if I want to have him in. Yeah, I can't bring him in like that. What do you have? Kick. I do want to try him out. It will try him out. Alright, I think that will do. Why don't you go find out how the battle will go? Oh, ooh, it's very bright here.
Uh-huh.
No way.
He's not fully healed up either.
That's a
good
idea.
Hold on.
Up there. We have to stop them before they can warn anyone.
Oh, yes. The one character that I had to do that.
What is it?
Yes.
Well, yeah, the one character I had it? For that. Hmm? Unless you can do something about it. Let's find out. Blast. I don't know her abilities yet. No, that won't do it. What about that one? Scorch? No. Blast. That'll do it. Wow. Holy hell. The magic is very powerful. Okay, and you have Mighty Blow, Kick, and Scare. Okay, well, let's bring you over here. So you have to go. Go grab that orc. You'll do that. Okay. I'll let those two fight over there. We'll head over here. I think. Is there a way for me to get up there? Oh, do I really have to go around like that? Oh, wow.
Yes. At once.
Okay, come on, let's go.
Understood.
We'll go help out, because we have to. I do wish she would use her abilities on her own. Alright, we'll scare them. Oh, that really does work effectively, I mean. Yeah, he's a very visceral character. Very violent. I like it. Okay, you finally made it over here. We can go finish more of them. Okay. Well, you do that. She's back down. I want to try more abilities. I haven't really tried a lot of them. Wonderful. Okay. She's gonna need more magic. She's very quick. I like her movement too. No kidding. Oh, wow. Definitely digging her combat abilities. Wow. That's power. Okay, did you finish off? Okay, you did not. You definitely did not. Let's go knock more off. I'm gonna lure them over here. Blast a few off. I was hoping to get more blasted off, but that'll work. Okay. Well, he's fighting. We should be able to move on. I'm thinking we can anyway. These two have definitely changed the game for me. I like Bo and Dill. He's cool. I enjoy him, but having the magic, man, very powerful. Whoa. That's powerful. We need to watch out for the ogre. Did I zap my own guy? Yeah, I did. For Jaren, whatever his name is. Alright, finally one more. Oh, no, two more. My bad. I need to finish him off quickly. Oh, we're not done yet? Shoot. Come on, knock him down. You got him, Bowendall. Okay, now we can bring you back over here. Hold on, I need to move you.
As good as done.
Hold on. There's one of me. One more. I wanted him to go. Yeah, we'll just bring him ourselves. That's gonna happen. He'll just follow. Okay. We'll knock a few down. Or back. Whatever we need to do. Oh, I thought I hit her too. I was a little bit worried about that. I think I did, though. Maybe. God, you need to watch out for that ability. Potent, very potent. I can easily hit my friends. It's very bright here. It's why I'm having a hard time seeing. Whoa. That's a lot.
Alright. Say goodbye forever. As good as done.
Huh? Alright, Tungdil. I need you to charge through. And help him out.
Do you think he's smart?
Look at the ogre.
Wait a moment.
Yeah, I'm not trying to let you die. Hold on. I'll move you back real quick. Your friend is doing a lot of damage. She'll be okay. Whew. Beautiful kick. Let's go now. We'll scare a few away. I'm working the ogre, unfortunately. Oh, yeah, it does affect my own friends. Man, gotta watch out for that.
Now you've got me interested.
Okay, now you can come over here and help me out, too. Does she heal like automatically? Maybe it's like a trait of hers. I don't know. I haven't really looked at her traits.
With pleasure.
I didn't hit you very hard. Yes.
Okay. Let's go over here and blow them back.
On my way.
Oh no. Okay, we need to get away from that ledge right now.
All right.
Do not need to be near a ledge. That's really bad. Get rid of one ogre. Yeah. Tungdil's still trying to do his thing. Oh, whoa. Whoa. Was that her?
Another one bites the dust. Yeah.
Yeah, Jaren's incredibly strong. Oh, that kick is really effective too. All right, one moving. Oh, they have artillery. No wonder. I was wondering what was going on. One back here. Okay, she did follow. Maybe they will follow after like a period of time. They'll just begin to move on, help you out.
Not a bad idea.
Oh, I was hoping they would all. Taken care of by that.
Yes.
Nope. I'll bring you over here. You'll go join him. Oh, I'll have her look around real quick.
If I have to.
There's gonna be more of them eventually.
All right, then. If I have to.
Maybe.
Not a bad idea. All right then.
Not all right. Let's go finish off what they have.
Yeah.
There we go.
As good as done.
They're all gone. Yes. I think we got them all.
If I have to.
Yeah, we got them all. Let's keep on moving.
As good as done.
If I have to.
I just need to reach the exit, right? Hold on, I want to look over here. Have they just added location without it didn't really have anything for me to look at. I guess they would. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, found a catapult. Okay. I like how they're still firing, even though we're up here. Yeah, we found them.
I didn't hit you very hard.
We'll get the other one too. Jaren, we'll have you head over here. Yeah, kick that thing. There we go. Very good. Okay. Oh, did you not hit it? I guess you didn't. Okay, what about Endokai?
Now you've got me interested.
We'll try. I'm still trying to get a grip on her abilities. That's cool. Didn't do what I wanted, but hey. Alright, we got it. That shouldn't be a lot of experience. Now we're gonna head to the exit. So we're gonna have four characters. Tungdil's gotta go. I mean, in terms of going into each battle. We all made it though. I wonder what would happen if we all didn't make it.
Go down into the caves and vaults. There'll be more of them down there.
Or maybe we should concentrate on finally getting to Ogre's Death Stronghold, Boindil.
You ignore the offended look on your friend's face and set off, leaving the Orc Mountains behind you.
Yeah, we gotta go. Can't just wait there. That's a terrible idea. It wouldn't be good, I can tell you that much. Oh. There's a lot of leveling up. Okay, damage boost. Defense bonus, I mean. To give him sweep and charge. We don't really have a normal tank, do we? Yeah, alright. Wait, what about the other characters? Do they not have new abilities to pick up? I guess not. Yeah, you like me a lot. That's good. Okay, we're gonna call it here. When we're back, we'll keep on moving on and finally get to Ogre's Death, and that should be a lot of fun. We need to get food soon, too. Thank you for watching. Please do not forget to leave a like down below if you did enjoy the episode, and check out my channel and the other videos, too. And as always, until then,